Okay, hello everyone, Samantha here. I'm just going to, in this video, quickly show I'm going to fix the inside cover of this journal that I made over with gift paper and an acrylic paint pen. And then I want to share some upcoming challenges that I'm going to have, and anyone can join me. If you hear me, I'm still kind of congested. I actually was sick the entire weekend. I was in bed the entire weekend. I was able to, after I uploaded that washi tape video, I haven't been in my creative space really. I did try to do a little bit of journaling here and there, and I uploaded a video. It's easy for me because in bed I was able to just like snap photos of my journal and just, you know, put it together and upload it. So, just battling a cold, I actually had to end up going to the ER yesterday. I tried to go to work. Long story short, the doctor prescribed, gave me some medicine, and now my chest was clear and everything. Thank God for that. No infection or anything. It would have been wise if I would have stayed home and took a day's rest. But I didn't want to do that because it was a Monday, and I'm calling out on a Monday and Friday, you know, it's not right. And I know better, like, it's about my health. I know that I'm not lying, so what people think, that's not on me. But still, I still felt better to try to go to work. But it ended up happening, and I ended up in the emergency room. I'm not going to go into how that happened. And thank God I'm home today. I'm resting, and the doctor gave me the day off. Gave me a note for the day off, and so I do feel much, much better this morning. There's still some congestion, and I, God willing, I'll be going to work tomorrow. But I'm okay to be sitting up. It's just that no overexertion. So yeah. So with that being said, let me just go on to what I was saying. What I was doing here. So I'm actually just going to fix the inside cover of this, and yeah, I'm not going to talk so much through this. I mean, this is not major. This is not anything major. Actually, I'm kind of struggling to do it, as you can see. Maybe that's because I'm talking and I need to be quiet. But yeah, so I'm going to do that. But then what's more important is that I wanted to share these the challenges that I wanted to do. I really just said I was going to, I really wanted to just show this because I said that I was going to do it, and maybe, I mean, as simple as it may seem, sometimes these things do help someone. So, yeah, so let me go ahead. I'm going to cut that out. And, yeah, so I'm not going to talk through this process because I need to concentrate. I think if I was, like, totally, like, not battling this whole cold thing or whatever, it would be different for me. But, you know, it's just, I think I even feel still a little shaky and stuff. All right. Okay, so I'm back, and as you can see, I had to end up going with this. That little mechanism tape adhesive thing, it broke on me. I dropped it a couple of times, so I may have, you know, messed up the inside of it at the cup when I dropped it and didn't realize it. So it was off course, the tape part, and it was just a mess. I tried to fix it, but I couldn't, so I just end up tossing it and then just taking this out. I was trying to use that up before I used this, but this was actually easier anyway, and the tape is really good. I could have put some here in this corner, which I'll probably go back at another time and put some, like, you know, put a little bit of matte medium in there. I won't do that now, but it just looks a little better. So I'm going to show a couple of pages I've done in this so far. Like I said, it was for Jesus Journal Junkies, and I've been sick and battling. So, you know, I didn't really, like, go. Well, you know, I still tried to do some kind of journaling because I wasn't, like, really in a good mood and stuff on top of that. But anyway, I don't want to go into that. Okay, so I'll just go ahead and share some of what I've been doing in here so far. The Jesus Journal Junkies group. This is some personal writing, so I'm not going to show that. But right here is, I wrote peace. And then, you know, I put some stickers. I drew some little whimsical flowers there. And I wrote the scriptures, Philippians 4:4-7. Rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say rejoice. Let your moderation be known unto all men. The Lord is at hand. Be careful or be anxious for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God. And the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your heart and minds through Christ Jesus. Philippians 4:4-7. And I can't share these thoughts because they are, like, not for the sharing. With some really hardcore stuff that you know, the Lord revealed to me that was in my heart, and so I'm not sharing that to anyone because that's private, and I would be embarrassed if I shared that. So and then this right here said woman in waiting, and right here I just wrote the scripture that night. My soul waits silently for God alone, for my expectation is from him. He only is my rock and my salvation. He is my defense. I shall not be moved. And God is my salvation and my glory. The rock of my strength and my refuge is in God. Trust in him at all times, you people. Pour out your heart before him. God is a refuge for us. Selah. Psalm 62:5-8. And that night, I don't know. I don't think I wrote anything in any other journal. Just right here, I wrote, God is my refuge. And you know, now that I think about it, like, when sometimes when you're waiting on the Lord and your patience is being developed and everything like that, it can be very trying. And, you know, the enemy, he comes to try to strike and say all kind of craziness, but, yeah. But God, that's all I'll say about that. Sometimes you can't say too much when you're going through. That's really, really where I am now. Like, the Lord is really dealing with me, with my patience. And hold on, I actually remember I got these books from the Dollar Tree. I actually have all 9 of them. Matter of fact, let me show them. I'm currently doing a prayer journaling series on the fruit of the spirit, and I'm actually gonna try to do the last page today. Self-control, but I have patience, peace, kindness, gentleness, self-control, which is the one I'll be doing today, and I'll be completed for that series. Faithfulness, love, goodness, and joy. But I'm really being tested on this, and it was so funny because when I went to come by over here by the table to do this video, this one was peeking out at me. I pulled it out. I said, which one is this? And I was like, yep, that's just what the Lord is dealing with me with. So it's more personal. Then I did this one, godliness with contentment is great gain. And I wrote out the scriptures, Hebrews 13:5-6. Let your conversation be without covetousness, and be content with such things as ye have. For he have said, I will never leave thee nor forsake thee. So that we may boldly say, the Lord is my helper, and I will not fear what man shall do unto me. And then I wrote 1 Timothy 6, 6, 8, because when I was looking up contentment, you know, actually this scripture came to mind, and then I just looked it up. But godliness with contentment is great gain, for we brought nothing into this world, and it is certain we can carry nothing out. And having food and raiment, let us be there with content. And then I wrote some personal notes. So I only did 3 pages, and today is what, day 8, but I'm taking my time because I'm battling. Well, I don't know. Anyway, so I'm going to be reading that. So anyway, on to these challenges that I wanted to share. Hold on. So this is a little bit different, but I want to share it here. And then I think I'm going to actually splice this video and share this portion in my playlist for Modest Woman. And this challenge is not a really an art challenge at all. It's more about a health challenge. So I'm going to show this picture on right now. So this is a challenge that I'll be doing. And if anyone wants to join in, and I'm not going to create, you know what, maybe I will create a Facebook group for it. If I get just one person that wants to do it, I will create a Facebook group for it. And because sometimes it's not about the masses, it's about maybe that one that just needs someone to journey along with them. And so I don't want the group to be stressful. I don't want it to be a group where people are just showing off. I really want it to be just where we can really like support and help each other on our health and for our health and fitness needs. Yeah, so I'll start the challenge in there, and then if I get the group up, if I get some, I'll just continue with different health and fitness challenges. Nothing so extreme. I know some people are at different levels in their you know, how can I say, different people are at different levels when it comes to exercising and how they eat or whatever. And I just want to make it like a challenging yet comfortable environment. So there will be challenges there, but I mean, what's stressful for me may not be stressful for another person, and what's not stressful for me may not be challenging for another person. So, you know, people will have the opportunity to share challenges as well. But this is the first challenge that I'm going to be doing, and I will be posting videos like vlogs about it. I had started that, I think it was last summer, and I kind of fell off the bandwagon with it. But I'm getting back, I've been back on track with my eating, and this is the journal that I've been using, Food for Thought. And I like this. I will share, like, it has like what you ate for breakfast, lunch, dinner, snacks, and you know, it's very colorful, so I like it. So like this one particular day, it wasn't the best meal, but I put, because it's about, you know, being honest and, you know, just getting back on track and being healthy or whatever. So what I ate for breakfast, I did banana and coffee. And then for lunch, I had oxtail, mac and cheese, and cabbage. But I had a very small portion. And with these, I didn't put the times these days. I don't know why I didn't do that. I don't count calories anymore. To me, that's just nerve-wracking. There will be certain days I might look at the calories, you know, but it's not something that I, how can I say, like, I'm a stickler with. Because I just feel like when you eat real food and you're mindful and you eat things in moderation, you're living. You're living, and it won't be so bad with the calorie count. It could be, but so bad. I mean, we know when we're gorging ourselves versus, like, eating what's right for our bodies. So at any rate, let me move on from there. And you know, I'm still like battling, so if I seem a little bit like all over the place, whatever, just forgive me please. So then So I don't want to show that because that part is I was right here. I wrote food is fuel, daily activity log. So I wrote what I did for exercising. And then down here it says mind, body, soul, daily meditation. And let me see. No, I can't share that. well, can I? Let me see. Okay. No, I'm not gonna share that because that's just. Well, you know, I'll share the first part. I'll share that first sentence. I wrote struggling mentally and emotionally. So, yeah. But I'm here today. God got me over that hump, so don't wanna focus on that. So, food of the day, like your favorite food of the day. And I will have to honestly say that favorite food of the day was the orange juice. What day was this that I wrote this? Was this? Oh, yeah. But for whatever reason, that day, the only thing that I really enjoyed was the orange juice. And I wrote, it says, what does it taste like? What does it smell like? Where did you get it? How yummy it is. And I, you know, drew a sketch of a cup of juice right there. So, tasty reflections. I wrote, how do you feel about today? I wrote, it was better than yesterday. Sometimes I don't have a lot of thoughts, so I don't force it. I wrote it. It says here, what was the best thing you ate? I don't really like much of what I ate. I enjoyed the juice more. I think the cabbage was good. Food goals for tomorrow: drink more juice, forgo food, drink more water, no bread. And I don't. When I drink juice, I water it down, so it's not like. How can I say It's not fake juice. It's either orange juice, apple juice, or 100% orange, 100% grape, or 100% apple. And I will put some, what is it? Some seltzer water or some water. Make it real cold. So it's not like I drink large cups of juice at a time. Then activity goals for tomorrow: crunches, leg work, arm work. And then over here it says recipe corner. And it says tonight, I ate the oxtails that I have bought, the leftover oxtail. And that's what that night. That's funny. Okay, it's not the best eating day, but it's not the worst. I hope to drink more water and juice tomorrow. I don't want to eat a lot of food. I'm hoping just to do a juice for veggies and dinner. So, and you know, it's a lot of space here for me to write, but I didn't feel like writing it. So anyway, so you know, we'll be able to you can journal. I don't know if you have a food and exercise, a health and fitness journal. Maybe you want to make one, or you know, you could write in a notebook. I got this from Recollection from or from Michael's. It's a Recollections. This is one of them that I got when I ordered them, that they were $4.99, and I saw on Facebook that they were having a sale again. So I don't know if you're on Facebook, but maybe you'll see that they have these journals for sale again. They're normally $9.99, but it's a nice journal. You see right here, it's normally $9.99, but they have it on sale for $4.99. So that's one challenge. So hold on. Oh yeah, I forgot to say the date. So this challenge will start Monday. Monday, yeah. Well, not sorry, guys. That will be Monday, yeah, Monday, May 21st. Yeah, no, not the 21st, the 14th. Monday, May 14th, right? So that's when that challenge will start. So, yeah, so, yeah, that's when I'll start. I think the group will be secret. So yeah, I think the group will be secret. So if you want to be in the group, what you can do is just like probably just depending upon how you feel, you can put in the comments, or you can just email and say put me in the group. 'Cause I realize that some people don't like people to know what groups they're in. So some people prefer secret groups. Some people prefer closed groups. Some people care whether it's public, closed, or secret. You know, but I think for this group, I want it to be secret. So, because I don't want it to be about, oh, who's in the group or how many people are in the group. I just don't. I just can't deal with all the pomp and circumstance. It doesn't work for me mentally and emotionally. So maybe one day it will, but it's a lot of stuff that comes with it and a lot of thoughts that come with it that I just can't deal with. So not at this time in my life. So anyway, so the second challenge is creative lettering. So what I'll be doing is looking through this book and also like this book right here, Whimsical Lettering. And I've mentioned this book before. I've showed this book, but I've mentioned this book before, how one of the things that Joanne Sharp talks about is like developing your own handwriting. And even though, you know, I have my calligraphy books and everything like that, and you know, I've started before trying to do calligraphy and folk calligraphy, and it's something that I'm interested in. I'm also very much into, sorry about that, the window's open. I'm very much into developing my own handwriting and my own font style. So, starting this challenge will also be starting on Monday, the 14th, for 30 days. That's Monday, May 14th, for 30 days. Just choosing one word, and just being creative with it. I mean, like, being creative with that one word on a page. It could be on a blank page. It could be on a background. It could be on notebook paper. It could be on your wall. It could be on a shirt, whatever. Just one word a week that... And you know, one word a day. I'm going to do one word a day. Whoever wants to join in can. You don't have to do a video every day. You don't even have to show show it if you don't want to. Maybe it's something that you just want to do privately. Or you want to post on Instagram and then put... I'm going to put a hashtag. Hold on. So, I had to think of that. So, it'll be GE My Own Hand. GE My Own Lettering. I'll just say My Own Lettering. GE. I put GE because somebody may have My Own Lettering, but I doubt anyone have GE, and you know that's Glory Express. So GE My Own Lettering. And so, you know, every day choose a word. It could be any word. And you could do your own writing. So maybe if I wanted to do something like this, and it doesn't mean that it won't look like something out there. Because, you know, we live in a world where we see images, and those images are in the archives of our mind. And we might even produce something similar to someone else that we do know. So, like, something like this. So, if I wanted to do like that, I could have left it the way that it was. But then a person might get fancy with it, and they may want to put some, you know, doodles or whatever. You know, in their lettering, rather. And so, yeah. So, that's going to start May 14th. And I think I'm going to try, since this is not hard to do, I'm going to challenge myself to upload it daily, because it'll be about a minute or two, if that. But, you know, it's fun. And then if I upload something and somebody wants to, you know, use that lettering, I don't even mind. I don't even mind for the challenge. So that's that. I want to do another challenge too. A Bible drawing challenge. But I'm going to wait till some things get squared away over here on my end before that, because that I want to use a little bit more materials and that right now, that will be a bit more extensive, and I can't do that right now. Hopefully within the next 2 weeks or so. We'll see. I don't know. I just, right now at this point, I have no choice but to trust God and wait on Him. It's like, yep. And sometimes we're just in those places where we don't have any other choice. And some people say, yeah, you have a choice. Well, I don't have a choice at all. I don't have a choice in and of myself that's going to have a good outcome, I'll tell you that. So, if I know what's best for me, I better wait. Bottom line. So, but at any rate, so that's it for those two challenges. And sorry if I seemed a bit like wonky when I was talking and stuff like that. You know, that happens when I'm tired or when I'm just battling, or even sometimes when I'm just going through, you know, life challenges. You know, that happens. But it's on my heart to share something right now. God will do that. You know, the other day, my husband and I were talking, and he was talking to me about the whole prosperity message and how some of it we have to be very careful of, because it can send the wrong message if it's not conveyed properly. You know, we all go through things. You know, there's scriptures that, you know, lets us know that we will experience suffering and things of that sort. And one of the things we've discussed this before, that it can actually leave a person disenfranchised if they believe that they are not going to suffer and not going to experience things that create hardship, and have encounters with people, and those encounters are unjust, unfair. If we don't understand that we too, as Christians, loved by God, and God having our best interests at heart, still will go through these things, we can become very, very disenfranchised. We can even get so angry with God, you know, that it's not even like warranted. But it can happen if the individual was taught that they will always get what they want, and the outcome will always be what they initially want, and there'll be no mention that God has a plan. And that is just not true. That is just not true, because God has a plan and He knows what's best for us. And you know, I'm very careful when I read things that say that God's gonna do everything that I want Him to do for me, and boom, boom, boom. I'm learning to be careful not to receive it and to not preach it, to be careful. I think it's unintentionally harmful. It's people a feel good, but it's not biblical. It is not in a biblical construct. When we look at what Paul went through, and other saints of the Bible that were in the hall of faith, the believers in the book of Hebrews 11, they too suffered and faced disappointments. There are those messages where God encourages our heart, and you know, but we have to know our hope is in Him. Our hope can't be in Him doing what we want Him to do, because what we initially want may not be the plan of God. And He knows what's best for us. He's made us promises, and it will behoove us to understand those promises from the Bible and getting His interpretation of it so we won't be deceived. And that's a lifetime journey. And I noticed too, like, I notice, like, if I, should I say this, Lord? put it like this. There's more in general in life, there are more amens when there's that prosperity message versus get your life right with Christ. You just watch, look around you, you see it. If you see it on social media, you see it in church, you see it in conversation with people, you see it amongst family and friends. If you preach God gonna do this for you and God gonna do that for you and you're gonna get this and you're gonna get that and he will give you the desires of your heart, not realizing it says if you delight yourselves in him and your heart begins to change and get in alignment with him, there's no mention of that. Oh, you watch how many amens and applause and accolades you will get. But start, watch when there's, we have to repent. God has a plan.
The answer is no.
We have to submit to God. God changes us. He transforms us. He wants to renew our mind. God, we got to surrender our will. We got to pick up our cross. When those messages go out, they are not the feel-good messages. They are not... Those kind of messages don't get the greatest applause or accolades or amens. They get some because there's a remnant in this earth's realm, but in comparison, you'll see.
I admit at times my first response is not always amen and hallelujah.
And it's just because, you know, the nature of the flesh, it does not want to hear that. It just doesn't. It'll kick up against the pricks. It'll just, you know, it fights God. The Bible lets us know the spirit lusts against the flesh and the flesh lusts against the spirit. They're at war with each other.
But thank God for his mercy and grace to enable us to say amen to him.
And so, yeah, so I don't know. I just had to share that. And I just had to share that. I don't know. God knows. Oh my good God. Well, anyway, so that's it. I want to say thanks for watching. God bless you. And remember, Jesus loves you. Bye-bye.